personal insults, name-calling, repeated interruptions. That's how the first presidential debate between Republican nominee Donald Trump and Democratic rival Joe Biden went down. Biden went as far as calling Trump the worst U.S. president ever.
Yeah, I do want to respond. Look, the tax code that made him, put him in a position that he pays less tax than a school teacher makes, on the money a school teacher makes, is because of him he says he's smart because he can take advantage of the tax code. And he does take advantage of the tax code. That's why I'm going to eliminate the Trump tax cuts. And I'm going to eliminate those tax cuts and make sure that we invest in the people who, in fact, need the help. People out there need help.
But why didn't you do it over the last 25 years?
Because you weren't president. Because you weren't president screwing things up.
You were a senator.
You're the worst president America has ever had.
Hey,
Joe,
let me just tell you, Joe. I've done more in 47 months. I've done more than you've done in 47 years, Joe.
Well, let's discuss this now with Professor John Stremler, Honorary Professor of International Relations at Wits University. Good evening, Professor. So I think at one point Joe Biden even told Donald Trump to just shut up. I mean, it really wasn't very presidential. Is it possible to say who won that one?
Yes, it is possible to say, and viewers seem to have had that same opinion, and I've heard a lot of commentary in South Africa today about this, so your viewers probably know that it was a shambolic, sorry spectacle, but that this sort of debate shouldn't occur in a democracy. But Biden clearly won.
And why do you say that?
Well, because he maintained dignity. He appealed to national unity. He talked directly to the voters. He ignored Trump's non sequiturs contradictions, pointed some of them out, but just pressed on with trying to get some core messages across that, for the viewers who are trying to make up their mind, most of them have made up their mind, by the way, but for those who haven't, that he really can bring back a sense of normalcy, political capacity, capability to deal with things like the COVID crisis. And of course, one of the things that is really at the heart of the last night's debate that hasn't gotten much commentary is that women, who are now, you know, majority of the voters in the U.S., would be, I should think, really offended by the bullying tactics. He used those against Hillary Clinton. He tried to use them against Biden. But nevertheless, it is a tendency to talk down to people that women have known forever. And so they just don't want it anymore. And with Kamala Harris as the promise of a new America, more diverse and more capable, I think you're going to see a really interesting debate between she and Mike Pence in a week.
I'm wondering if it would be a good idea, if Trump's team is considering whether to cancel the next debate, which is sometime in October, because on the one hand, as you say, it really was not very presidential, and he is the incumbent, so it doesn't cover him in glory. On the other hand, the counter-argument might be that he's speaking to his base, and they like that he comes across as tough and macho.
Yes, there's no question that his base likes it, but his base has never been more than 40% of the public, and remember, he lost the popular vote in 2016. There are distortions in the American Constitution that favor small, rural, evangelical Christian, predominantly white states, and that has to be come to terms with. So Biden has to win substantially to clear the Electoral College and the popular vote. But Trump's base has never, ever crossed 50%. And he's really got it down even narrower now. He's trying to mobilize a high turnout. But women and suburbanites and elderly people who are at risk of COVID, I think, are going to show that Biden has the majority that his polling for months has shown. And it could only increase, I think, after last night's terrible performance by the bully Trump.
You know, presidential debates are a U.S. tradition, certainly, I think, at least from the 1960s, if not earlier. But historically, the person who wins the debate, and you say it was clearly Joe Biden, does that actually impact the outcome at all? Is there a correlation?
Well, you unfortunately remind me of my age, because I saw the first debate, which in many ways was a defining moment in the campaign between John F. Kennedy and Richard Nixon. And Kennedy far exceeded expectations. It was a very close election, and it probably made an important difference. Whether or not these debates have mattered in all of the years that I've watched them all is always debatable, and probably at the margins there is an impact. Certainly there was an impact in 1980 when Jimmy Carter was running against Ronald Reagan, and that was the biggest audience, by the way, I think so far. We're interested to see how many people watched last night. I'm sure there'll be a fall off. But this can only help advance Biden and undermine confidence, except in his base, in the leadership of Donald Trump, which has been so wanting. I mean, 209,000 dead of COVID when we're only 4%, America's only 4% of the population. It's 20% of the dead. Something's wrong.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for your time. We really do appreciate it. Professor John Stramler, Honorary Professor of International Relations at Wits University.